Okay, in this calculus lesson, let me show you guys how we can use the good limit forms to help us determine limit. What are the good limit forms? Well, they are right here. Any time that we see any of these forms when we are dealing with limits, we actually get to draw a conclusion. Remember, these are the bad ones. We have 7 bad ones here, but the ones that I put down in the box right now, they are the good ones. And let me demonstrate how we can make this work. Let's take a look at the first example. Let's say if we have the limit as x approaching 2 plus 1 over ln of x minus 2. And usually, I'm not going to write down like this is equal to whatever, because this is more like scratch work, because I wanted to figure out the answer. So usually I will do this. I'm just going to first put down this into x and then see what happens. And I'm just going to write it down below and then I will see. We have 1 over ln parentheses, and then the x is now 2 plus, and then we still have that minus 2. Okay, and I'll be drawing arrows because technically we are doing limits. So the first thing that we can do is, we know 2 minus 2 is 0. So it looks like we just have 1 over ln of 0. But hold on one sec, because this is actually 2 plus. When we have 2 plus minus 2, this will actually give us 0 plus. What this means is 2 plus is like 2.001, because we're approaching 2 from the right hand side. So it's slightly bigger than 2. And then when we subtract 2 after that, well, we get like 0.001. So in another word, we are getting towards 0 from the right hand side. That's why we have the plus here. Then on the bottom, we have that ln 0 plus. Can we draw a conclusion? Yes, and the conclusion is that this will give us negative infinity. Why? Because I know you guys have watched my previous video and take good notes. If not, it's right here, right? Remember the graph for natural log? As x approaching 0 plus, the graph goes straight down. We have a vertical asymptote there. So that's why it's negative infinity. And then now we have the 1 over negative infinity. What's the result? It will give us 0, because a finite number over infinity. It's negative though, but doesn't matter. Negative 0 is still 0. Finite number divided by infinity, it's going to be 0. And that's the indeterminate. That's a good limit form right here. Right? That's a good limit form. So finally, I will just go back to the question and put down this is equal to 0. And usually, I will just show this kind of work. Some people might not like this, but I think it's pretty good. All right, now let's take a look at another example. Let's say here we have the limit as x approaching 3, x over x minus 3. And of course, let's go ahead and try to plug in 3 into all the x's and see what happens. It looks like we have 3 over, and then we have another 3 here, and then minus 1 more 3. And it looks like the top is still 3, and the bottom is 3 minus 3, which is 0. Oh no, this is 3 over 0. The answer to this is not undefined, because we are doing limits. And what do we do though? Are we going to get past infinity or negative infinity? Well, we have to check the sign. And now this is the situation that we have a non-zero number over 0. Make sure we check the sign. And in fact, when we have the limit as x approaching 3, there's no plus or minus. Make sure we do both. So let's first check the limit as x approaching 3 from the right hand side. And of course, we have this function. Now let's plug in 3 plus into all the x's. So we get 3 plus over 3 plus and then minus 3. So what does that give us? On the top is 3 plus, on the bottom, 3 plus minus 3 is 0 plus. And as we can see on the top, this is like 3.001, so it's positive. On the bottom, it's like 0.0001, that's like positive. So we get positive infinity. So the answer for this limit is positive infinity. On the other hand, if we have the limit as x approaching 3 from the negative side, x over x minus 3, if you plug in 3 minus, we get 3 minus on the top over 3 minus minus 3. All right, the top is 3 minus, the bottom. Be careful with this. 3 minus 3 is 0, but 3 minus minus 3 gives us 0 minus. Because this right here is like 2.999, and then when we take away 3 from that, it's a negative result. So that's why it's negative number, right? So it's 0 minus. And now be really careful with this. What's the answer though? On the top is 3 minus, but it's really saying like 2.999, which the top is a positive number, and the bottom here is negative number. Divide, you get negative infinity. So this right here gives us negative infinity. So as you can see, the left limit and the right limit, they are not the same. So the original limit does not exist. Right, let's take a look at the third example and have this one for you guys. The limit as x approaching 1 of inverse tangent of 1 over x minus 1. Well, if we plug in 1 into this x, we get 1 over 1 minus 1, which is just 1 over 0. But 1 over 0, is it going to give us infinity or negative infinity? Well, we have to check the sign. So we are going to break this apart into two pieces, just like what we did for number 2. So let's first do the limit as x approaching 1 from the right hand side. And then this is inverse tangent of 1 over x minus 1. All right, so put 1 plus into x, we get inverse tangent of 1 over 1 plus and then minus 1. And this will approach inverse tangent of 1 over 1 plus minus 1 is 0 plus. And then what does that give us? Well, 1 over 0 plus is infinity, so this is inverse tangent of positive infinity. And then inverse tangent of infinity is, that is pi over 2. So that's the first part, we get pi over 2. But on the other hand, if we have the limit as x approaching 1 minus of inverse tangent of 1 over x minus 1, here we will get inverse tangent of 1 over 1 minus and then minus 1. This will approach inverse tangent of 1 over 1 minus 1 is 0, but 1 minus and then minus 1 is 0 minus. And then this right here will give us inverse tangent of 1 over 0 minus is negative infinity. And then inverse tangent of infinity, that will give us negative pi over 2. So when we approach 1 from the left hand side, this will give us negative pi over 2. And as we can see, these two limits are not equal. Therefore, the original limit does not exist.